let us quickly see what all we have gone through determinants till now. We have learned how to evaluate them. We have seen how to simplify them using properties. We saw how the concept of determinants can be used to find the area of a triangle whose vertices are given. In today's lecture, I will be including some of the terms which I had been using earlier in the previous sessions also. Let us see what they actually mean. So the two new terms we will be discussing today are minors and cofactors. Now you can see I have written the definition. We'll quickly go through them and try to understand. Minor of an element Aij of a determinant. That means if there is an element which is in ith row and jth column in a particular determinant, then minor of this element is a determinant obtained by deleting its ith row and the jth column in which this particular element is lying. So if I am talking about A11 and I have to obtain its minor, then I will delete its first row and first column. Because for A11, the value of I is 1 and the value of J is also 1. So when you are deleting the particular row and J of the particular row and the particular column of the given element of the determinant, its minor determinant will be obtained. Now generally we use the notation capital M for the minor. By writing the subscript ij, we mean for which element the minor is being calculated. Then is cofactor. Cofactor of an element aij, which will be either denoted using capital C or capital A. So the cofactor of aij can be denoted as capital C with I and J in the subscript or capital A with I and J in the subscript. It is defined by Cij is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus J times Mij. So the cofactor of a particular element can be equal to the minor or it can be negative of the minor. That will depend upon the sum of I and J. So if this sum comes out to be even, then the cofactor and the minor will be equal. If the sum comes out to be odd, then the cofactor will be the negative of corresponding minor. So for a general matrix, I have calculated the minor determinants. Suppose this is matrix A with the elements defined in each row and column. If I write its determinant, then I will have to put bars over here. If I convert this to determinant, then we need to change the notation here. So this is the notation for the determinant. So if we are talking about determinant of A with these elements in various position in rows and columns, then calculating for their minor elements, you can see M11 can be obtained if I hide or delete the first row and the first column. So if the first row and the first column are deleted, then the minor determinant will have these four elements. This we have obtained while evaluating the determinant also when we expand it. Okay. So this is M11. What about the cofactor corresponding to it? It will be minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1 times M11. Because here the sum is even, so this becomes M11 only. In the same way, rest of the minors are obtained. I will randomly pick up some more. Like suppose we are finding M22. So the second row and second column you will delete. When second row and second column are deleted, the four elements in the left out determinants are A11, A13, A31, A33. You can see that. And its cofactor can be written as minus 1 to the power 2 plus 2 times M22. So minus 1 to the power 2 plus 2 comes out to be plus 1. So C22 is equal to M22. Then look at M32. For M32, you will be hiding the third row and the second column. And the four elements left in the minor determinant, A11, A21, A13, A23. And you can see here, the sum of I and J is odd, it is 5. So its cofactor will be negative of the minor. One more minor element, minor we will have here, that will be for the element A33, which I am writing here. So the last minor for this has to be the one obtained by deleting the third row and the third column. So you delete the third row, the third column. The left out elements are A11, A21 in the first column, A12 and A22 in the second column. And what about the cofactor? Let us try it directly. You can see 3 plus 3 is 6. It is even. So it will be same as M33. So C33 is equal to M33. Okay, so this is how the minors and the cofactors of a determinant can be evaluated. Now a result relating to the concept of cofactors. It says if elements of any row or column of a determinant if elements of any row or column of a determinant be multiplied suppose they are multiplied by the cofactors of any other row by the cofactors of any other row or column then their sum will be zero. Fine, let us try it for the same determinant which we took. Suppose I am taking the elements of first row. So the elements of first row will be A11, A12, A13. What are they asking? They are saying if the elements of any one row be multiplied with the cofactors of some other row. Okay, so see, the second row elements will have cofactors C21, C22, C23. So, because I have already taken the elements of row 1, so I will be taking the cofactors of either row 2 or row 3. So, any one you can take. As per the result, if the elements of any row be multiplied with the cofactors of some other row, let me take the second row. So, element will multiply with the cofactor of corresponding element. So, A11 will have corresponding element A21 in the second row. So, the cofactor will be C21. In the same way, corresponding to A12, the element is A22. So, its cofactor will be C22. And A13 will have corresponding element A23 and its cofactor will be C23. So, you can see we have multiplied the elements of row 1 with the cofactors of some other row. Now, they are saying if these products be added, then the sum will come out to be 0. This can be easily verified. You can see we know the values of C21, C22, C23. If we substitute them here on evaluating it, it comes out to be 0. And if I write it in the form of a determinant, you will see I will find a new determinant where two rows will be identical. So that makes it 0. You simply put the value of C21, C22, C23 here. Okay. And simplify it. You just go for expanding it. You will see all the terms they get cancelled out and the value comes out to be 0. Okay, now coming to some questions related to it. Anyone we can do. Question number 2 from the exercise we can take. Part 1, it is of order 3 cross 3. So let us go for that. This is exercise 4.4. Question number 2, second part let us quickly take. We are given a determinant. We have to find its minors and cofactors. The determinant has elements 1, 3, 0 in the first column. Then we have 0, 5, 1 in the second column. And 4, minus 1, 2 in the third column. You have to write its minors and cofactors. So, let us quickly find the minors and cofactors. You know how they are to be obtained. So, we'll do the calculation directly. We'll write the minor and with that we will write its cofactor also. move from one element to other. First we'll do with first row, then second row, and then the third row. So we are writing M11. You know, for this, first row, first column are to be deleted. Okay, so what are we left with? These are the elements we are left with. Okay, you know how to solve a determinant of order 2. So calculate this quickly. 10 minus minus 1, that makes it plus 1. So this is 11. And what will be C11? C11 will be M11 only. So it is equal to 11. Quickly do. Already you do the sum of I and J. If it is even, both will be same. If it is odd, cofactor will be negative of the minor. Next one I am doing directly. See, M12. So first row, second column I will hide. So these are the four numbers I am left with. So 3 into 2, 6. Then minus 0 into minus 1, that is 0 only. So it is 6. What about C12? It will be minus of M12. So it is minus 6. Then M13, hide the first row and the third column. These are the four elements left. So 3 into 1, 3. Then minus 0 into 5, 0. So the sum comes out to be 3 only. Okay. What about C13? It will be same as M13, which is 3. Then M21. M21 means hide second row and first column. So keep in mind, these are the four elements left. Okay, so 0 into 2, 0. Then minus 1 into 4, which is 4. So M12 is coming minus 4. And what about this is M21. C21 will be minus of M21. So this becomes 4. Then is M22. Hide the second row and the second column. These are the four elements left. 1 into 2 is 2. Minus 0 into 4, which is 0. So the minor M22 is 2. And what about C22? It will be same as M22. So the cofactor is 2 only. Then moving on to M23. We have to hide second row and the third column. See, these are the four numbers left. So 1 into 1, 1. Minus 0 into 0, 0. So it is 1. And the corresponding cofactor will be minus of M23. So it is minus 1. You can quickly see where all I am putting negative sign. Where the sum of I and J is odd. Now moving on to the last row. M31. So third row and first column we are hiding. 0 into minus 1, 0. Then minus 5 into 4, 20. So this is minus 20. And C31 has to be same as M31. So it is also minus 20. There is M32. M32 will be obtained by hiding the third row and the second column. So these are the four elements left. So 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Then minus 3 into 4, 12. So this is minus 13. And what about C32? It will be minus of M32. So this becomes only 13. Then for the last element, M33, which we will obtain by hiding third row and third column. So these are the four elements we are left with. 1 into 5 will be 5. Then minus 3 into 0, which is 0. So this is 5. And C33 will be same as M33. So that comes out to be 5. Understood all of you?